Breaking news, just within the last hour, U of M students started returning to their homes after a gas spill led to an hours-long evacuation. This all started some 7 hours ago when authorities got reports of a fire and manhole covers flying off on University Avenue. And for several hours, this stretch, including part of campus, had to be evacuated. Devon Rahming has been there monitoring the situation for several hours and joins us now with the latest. Devon?
Well, Julie, as you mentioned, this stretch of university did open about an hour ago to students who live in this area. Many of them were cheering. They were excited to be able to get back into their residence after being held up. But the roadway still remains closed to traffic tonight as investigators process the scene.
It's just not good, I can't lie.
Heavy smoke and flames coming from the basement.
I probably shouldn't be here right now.
Evacuation orders.
A lot of students with stuff in this area. We're going to need to evacuate them out of this area.
Police, firefighters, and utility crews at the heart of Fraternity Row made for an intense afternoon on the University of Minnesota campus. Many students immediately receiving this alert.
Evacuate 17th Ave Residence Hall.
I was sleeping and I heard this loud bang.
Like, it was absolutely absurdly loud.
That bang, officials say, led to manhole covers being blown out of the street.
I think there was an explosion in one of the frats.
I wonder if we'll get another one.
It started with reports of a fire and smoke coming out of the basement of a nearby frat house.
And I was out here beforehand, and there was definitely the smell of like gasoline and whatnot.
Minneapolis Fire later confirming a flammable gas spill in the sewer line is most likely to blame.
Well, obviously, it was smelling like gas everywhere, so we had to leave.
Students within an 8-block radius were evacuated to nearby Northrop Auditorium.
From what I've heard, everybody's okay, and there was nobody in that area, but that's really scary.
Now, thankfully, we can confirm that no one was injured during today's terrifying blast, and city crews are still trying to investigate how gas may have gotten into the sewers. They're also working to recover the manholes. Julie.
All right. Thank you, Devon.